And here is the Writer's Almanac for Friday, January the 3rd, 2020. It was on this date, 1521, Martin Luther was excommunicated from the Catholic Church, having criticized the Church for selling indulgences for the forgiveness of sins, for which he could find no authority in Scripture. The Church accused Luther of heresy and gave him 60 days to recant. Luther replied by throwing the Pope's letter on a bonfire, so the Pope excommunicated him, 1521, on this date. It was on this date, 1777, George Washington and his army won the Battle of Princeton, sneaking up behind Cornwallis's army over frozen ground, fooling Cornwallis and his scouts by lighting campfires so that he thought that most of the colonials were on one side and the rest of the army came around from the other. The British retreated from New Jersey, which raised the morale of the Continental Army, and they began to believe that they could actually win this war. And today is the birthday of J.R.R. Tolkien, born in Bloemfontein, South Africa, 1892. Studied classics and language and literature at Oxford, and in 1925, he returned to Oxford as a professor. One day, grading exams, he discovered that a student had left one whole page in his examination booklet blank, and Tolkien, for reasons unknown even to him, wrote on the page, "In a hole in the ground, there lived a hobbit," a line that turned into a bedtime story that he told his children, and from that came his book, The Hobbit, in 1937. It's the birthday of Lucretia Mott, born Nantucket, Massachusetts, 1793. She was a teacher in a Quaker boarding school near Poughkeepsie, New York, and quit when she found out that she was being paid less than half of what the male teachers all made simply because she was a woman. She got into the women's rights movement, and along with Elizabeth Cady Stanton, she organized a convention for women's rights, the Seneca Falls Convention of 1848. Lucretia Mott, who wrote, "The world has never yet seen a truly great and virtuous nation, because in the degradation of women, the very fountains of life are poisoned at their source." It was on this day in 1899, the first known use of the word automobile in English. It was in the New York Times. Automobiles were still very new in 1899. The first mass production was a couple of years away. The New York Times was disturbed by the machines themselves and also the fact that there was no good word for them. It said they're all unutterably ugly, and never a one of them has been provided with a good or even an endurable name. The French had come up with the name automobile, half Greek and half Latin. Here's a poem for today by Claudia Surrea, Diversity Visa. When it carried our lives inside, how could the envelope be so small? We laughed and joked that we'd sleep under the Brooklyn Bridge. We'd eat a donut a day. We wondered if the New York streets would be dirty and crowded and paved with dreams. Would there be dogs with bagels up their tails? Would there be beautiful people like in the movies? Or would our life be a Seinfeld episode about nothing? Better poor in America than in Romania, we said. Would you do it again, you ask? With you, I answer, anytime. Diversity Visa by Claudia Surrea, from Nothing Important Happened Today, published by Broadstone Books and used by permission here on The Writer's Almanac. Be well, do good work, and keep in touch.